We are back again with another exhilarating session from Ms. Sita Motwani from Jubilant. She's an MSc Six Sigma certified black belt and ICIL D3 Foundation certified. Ma'am has an experience of 8.5 years contributing to various activities like process re-engineering, Lean Six Sigma projects, branding of quality and improvement initiatives, and Six Sigma trainings. She is currently handling Lean Six Sigma training portfolio, Six Sigma Green Belt and Black Belt projects, mentoring and business excellence corporate infrastructure related initiatives. She has been associated with organizations like Aviva Life Insurance, Tech Mahindra, MetLife, Airtel and Wipro. I invite you, ma'am, for the session.
That's what I wanted. That's the sound I wanted. Really nice thing, yeah. Well, I'm not an HR, I'm part of the business excellence team. I'll give you my introduction and I'll start with my organization. Have you connected?
Yeah.
Thank you. I'll just take a moment. We have a different line of businesses: food, retail, lifestyle, automobiles like Audi Park, GBMW. There were Domino's and Dunkin' Donuts. So you can see there's a diversification of the business we handle here. And we also have the global presence. In North America, China, we have got all the LOBs located across the globe. Business excellence person, you know, my role is to understand the opportunities in every line of business. Business excellence is a centralized department in the organization to take care of improvements across the LOB, across the function. HR is one of them. Primarily, when we thought about leading Six Sigma, you know, the one thing comes in our mind is it's primarily because of the manufacturing industry, both these concepts. One comes from scientific background, one comes from the manufacturing. We never thought of inclining these two concepts in service industry, specifically to HR domain. However, you know, recently, when in this agile environment, when we think people are, you know, things changes frequently. In the previous slide, we saw innovation, we talk about the skill gap, we talk about processes, various things. When we have people in place, we have processes in place, there is a scope of improvement. There are various opportunities we tackle. And there has to be approach so that the problem should not be surface again. A new innovation, new idea, whatever it can be. It cannot be just Six Sigma or Lean. It can be TRIP. New concept in the market altogether. The Russian concept. Have you ever heard about TRIP? Anybody? No, not yet? I'm sure you will. Go on Google about it. It's a new thing in the market. And this talk about is create your 38 academic field altogether. So maybe you're from an IT, you're from insurance, or you have completely
the innovation of the data point you have captured.
Yeah.
So what does Six Sigma mean?
Everything has been covered. All the data is
within those limits.
through a lot of learning in this Six Sigma, Lean process, and I think all of us could relate our subjects, basically BPR and Business Process Re-Engineering, NWO, Stats. I think we related everything in this session. Thank you so much, ma'am, for a lovely session, a very interactive and a very enriching session that we've had. Thank you. And I think I missed out on the bouquet in the beginning. So I request Nitin to give the bouquet. Thank you. I think I request Chetan to hand over the memento to ma'am. We're doing everything at the same time. Lean management. Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am. We need to give you the brochure.
Okay.
We launched it in the morning, so
wow.
And I was just wondering when 2 days back Rashmi called me out and said, Chuma, just 2 days, I don't know what to say about it. I'm not an MBA, I'm not an HR person, what did I say there? Just say, you know, try and relate. Yeah. Whatever you have your experience and all that. I said, I'll try to do it. And you know, the last interaction we were having, right? 4 companies, 5 years. I got 8.5 years and 6 companies. Don't take it on the negative way, guys. See, I told you one thing, any employer, they want value for the business, right? You have 10 across with you, XYZ certification. They just want to, you can see, you might have the certification, but you have the knowledge. That's the question. When you have, with the interviewers, you know, they ask you something, or maybe they are aware of something, and you're saying them, they will listen to you. They will say, okay, this man is something, which people I have, they're not aware of that. I'm not aware of that. This person is coming with that idea. I'm not a chemical engineer. I'm working with a drug manufacturing company, doing a project for them, mentoring a project for them, mentoring chemical engineer. So be part of whatever you're doing here and believe what you're doing here. You need to convince the other person. That's it. Stability is definitely one big factor. It might be a personal reason, or some of the reasons because of which you might have to switch completely. But the past is gone. You cannot change the past. Live in present again, work for the future. Prepare for yourself again, you know, ITIL V3 is a major opportunity for you guys. In 2014, most of IT companies have to be ITIL V3, you know, certified. So, a lot of opportunities. Think about it. Try and link up our experience, how you can sell it out. It's like selling yourself to the employers. But stability is very big important factor. Whatever the X, Y, reason has happened, please don't feel as a negative on your, you know, resume, or don't feel it. Send it down for that reason. So all the best, guys.
Thank you very much.